Yeah, I'm here at the Northwestern University in St. Paul, and this is where Officer Paul Elmstrand went to college and graduated. Professors tell me that before he even started taking classes, he already knew that he wanted to be a police officer. Professors tell me that for him, it was more than just a job. It was his purpose in life to serve other people and his community.
Paul had a clear sense of calling to be a peace officer. And he took it very seriously.
Professor Melissa Mork teaches psychology classes at the University of Northwestern. Many of those classes are required for criminal justice students like Paul Elmstrand.
He was fun. He was just a fun guy to have in class, a fun presence, and just a pleasure as a student.
A student who even wanted to learn outside the classroom. Burnsville police say while Elmstrand was in college, he was also working as a community service officer with their department. He was also involved in the Isanti County Law Enforcement Explorers program as a teenager.
He did all of the right things in his major and in his training. He took this so seriously, and he was so committed to the role.
Before going to Northwestern, Elmstrand was a 2015 graduate from Cambridge Isanti High School.
Well, Paul was an outstanding student here.
Retired activities director Mark Solberg says Elmstrand was his class president, was in the National Honor Society, ran cross country, and volunteered for their link crew, where he helped incoming freshmen transition to life in high school.
Not surprising that he chose to be a police officer because he was serving here years ago.
And Minnesota State University Mankato has confirmed that Officer Matthew Ruge, who also died in the shooting, was a 2018 graduate of Mankato, and Sergeant Adam Medlicott, who was injured in the shooting, graduated in 2007. In a statement, the president of the university says, "In every corner of the world, Mavericks are doing incredible and sometimes dangerous work. On days like these, we must remember that even in dark times, our community is strong and resilient." Back to you.
All right, Gordon, thank you.